everyone. Welcome to our live. Welcome to TinaVo.shop. So today, I want to do unicorn. I couldn't stand it anymore. Let me show you. I have to do this because it's a little bit past Easter because we only have like a few more posts. But I still want to go with the pastel color theme right there and add in some unicorn pattern to it. We're going to play with chrome and opal gel. I'm going to use opal gel today too.
In your website, baby.
So, that is my team today.
Oh.
Yeah, give me just a second. All right, let me pick my websites. So this is my inspo, my inspiration. Of course, the unicorn pattern have to be in there. Okay, let me see. My website is www.tinavo.shop. We are shipping worldwide, and I will add in color information for customer service. Color phone number is 417-772-4020. And I will connect myself. Hi, Australia. This is our Australian time.
Let's see. Oh, that's
Jenny. What? Oh. She having a birthday party and it's, I don't know how much is a ticket, but.
You gotta pay to go to her birthday?
Pay the ticket.
Listen, if you gotta pay to.
That's a $50 ticket or something. What you go? And then all this food and drinks to celebrate Jenny's birthday. Here you go.
Happy birthday, Jenny.
I wish I could made it.
Yeah.
But I don't think we have to pay, but.
Yeah.
All right, everyone. Stilettos. Turn this over. So pastel color theme first, I want to establish pigment first. So I'm choosing pigment base. Okay, apply all over. Let's start with the pinkies. All right. So I'm gonna put white on all. 5 nails.
All 5?
Yeah. Well, not the time. I'm gonna do it later with the video. Yeah. So I'm using pigment base. Smooth stroke.
Alright, baby.
Alright, put it over here. Next.
Hello,
yes. Hello, hello, Australia. It is our Australian time this week.
Hello, Giant Anthony.
Hello, Jen.
We got a disguise, Jen.
Okay.
Hello, Jen. Tanya. Aunt Deb.
Hi. Hola, tia Deb. ¿Cómo estás hoy?
The whole fan family's here.
Es buen día.
Fan family.
Hoy. Oh, muy lindo. Okay, now. There's a. Oh, arrivo. Oh, wait, no, not arrivo. Bonjour. Bonjour. Is it cat landing? Kid.
Oh, I thought. So I was reading back through to see if we missed any questions.
Uh-huh.
And one. When I read it and then it jumps, I didn't get to finish it for a second. And it said, I need your skin.
You need my skin?
Right, but it was skin regimen.
Oh.
It's better now. It's better now. I had the quickest flashback.
Okay. That was the second when I'm really excited or just upset or something. You need my skin. Oh, my skin regimen? I use Shiseido's. Shishito.
Ooh. Plus a whole bunch of other beautiful things. You act like you go and put on one cream.
Actually,
there's this. There's
it's a whole collection.
That, and there's that, and then there's this bottle for your eyes, and another one for.
I buy some masks from Korea. My friends sell it.
And then you put those damn masks on.
Yeah, my friends sell some masks in Korea. So every night I put the mask on. And that's the night that we watched that scary movie, Smile.
Oh my God.
And then I like, it's time for my mask. So when I put it on,
no, doesn't... you didn't say it's time for the mask.
I go ahead and put it on.
We watched the scary movie way too late in the evening that we should not have. And then you fell or was falling asleep as opposed to our normal schedule, which would be watch something funny. I went to the bathroom and I come back and you have the damn mask on.
And doesn't look at me with an eye of horrifying.
Because it was a dark room and it was a white mask.
And I look at him and say, what's going on? With my mask. It's a very high quality mask, so it's all white. Right. See my eye hole and the mouth. That's pretty much it.
It looked like Jason. And I'm like, you're not going to fall asleep with that.
Keep a secret setting.
So I can wake up every few hours, look at you, scare the shit out of myself. But because he loves me, it was masked.
I am selecting the color for your unicorn now. Now, I want to have white. I use a lot of white. I want to have white because I'm not looking for pure colors. I'm looking for pastel. So, okay, that should be it.
You got some really good comments. Hello, Nails by Nicole.
Hello, Nicole. Oh, you're going to see me soon, Nicole. I'm going to be in Orlando. If you're not busy that week, I would imagine Nicole will show up in Orlando premiere, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so first let's take the color out. Let's see what we got here. So we got blue. Let's blue to be this corner right here. With blue, let's go ahead and add a little green in and make the blue teal. So a little green, just a little bit, not much.
Honey.
And then white.
Give a shout out to
Viriff 65. Hello, Viriff. I want you one day to give me a shout out, please. I love your work. Hello, Viriff. Thank you, Viriff. See how I can just pronounce in a split second.
I don't know if you pronounced it correctly or correctly. I know I was.
Viriff.
I know. I would have said bye. Huh? You use beef to pay the cows, honey. So, I would have to say like Viva.
It's Barif.
I like the sound of the R.
Thank you. A lot of people do. I add a little blue in just to make it lavenders. Because I want the purple to be a little cooler.
So. Oh my. Did Marlene get in here?
Hi, Marlene. No, white, because I want it to be light.
Oh, my goodness. Yay! Okay, I was actually just getting ready to mention Marlene and tell everyone to thank. We love you, because we do, and... you're getting better.
Yes.
And you're winning.
Yeah. Manifestation.
I missed her.
Okay, pink. So on the pink, it's too bright. I want a dreamy unicorn.
Unicorn.
I want it to be dreamy. I need to make it lighter. Make it dreamy.
Oh, I'm so excited now.
Yes. Mm. We didn't see, do we see her for a while?
She abandoned us. And then I thought, how dare her? I mean, she doesn't do nails or anything. And then, but, you know, I thought we were family. And then, I don't even have a phone. I don't have any social media. And I went in and I figured out how to find her. And that was difficult for me, but I had to reach out and thank and send positive things and love, because that's how I feel about her. And I don't know why. Sometimes you can just love people without meeting them in person or communicating with them too much.
All right. We have our colors. Let's blend.
You have a successful road ahead of you, Marlene.
Now, I need a paper towel. So this is not my palette. That's my makeup palette. I'm going to put it right here. I need a paper towel. I need to clean this. All right. Okay. Now, where's my nails? Time to go ahead. I'm going to do the middle one first. Actually, the ring first. I'm going to do the ring first. Just because it's a main fingers.
The main.
Yeah, so let's see what we got here. Ooh, let's try this color for teals. So work it into your brush, tap it just a little bit, and come here, start from here, and blend away.
Blend away.
Blend away. If it's too heavy, then you just run it through the paper towel a little bit so it will get lighter for you. You will see.
So, as a non-nail tech artist, mm-hmm. I have a question.
Oh, okay.
So, we've been very, very muted or pastel-y or mm-hmm. just had us toned down. Are we ever going to brighten the world up?
I mean, not
after
yet.
Easter, can we pop into some... something shiny and fun and bright. And
we can pop, but we have to pop slowly.
We gotta pop slowly.
Yes, we have to ease into it like an assassin. Where they don't see it coming, they're like, ooh, beautiful pastel. And then bam, just one day, it just bipolar. Just, it's a switch. I like that reaction. I'm looking forward to it. Can be too obvious. You cannot expect it. You gotta tease it with colors. Purples. But still, you really get a claw in me this month. I never have chance to take Easter seriously, so this year I made up for all of it. Mm-hmm. For all my year of neglect. But still neglect, because I love bright color. I love neon. So after years and years of pastel neglect, I made enough for all of it today.
Okay, that's fine. So what I'm actually hearing, I hope, is we'll be done with it soon and add it out of your system?
Maybe.
Oh, man.
You're asking if tonight is the last night of pastel?
I'm still back on the slow pop. I'm trying to figure, where does that start and begin?
A magician never
revealed the tricks. And just to let you know, I was not thinking about nails and color at this point anymore when you said slow bang and...
It doesn't matter. A magician never revealed its tricks.
So you're just not going to tell me?
No. I'm going to be like an assassin.
I'm so disappointed right now.
See, I'm going to sneak in this pink right here.
Sneak it in.
Yeah, see that? See that? You'd be like, oh, this is a little cold. And then suddenly, bam. Just warmness right here. Just give all the attention over here. See that? Little blush. Change everything. Without it, it's a little pale, bland.
Okay, we got a question. Sometimes I have heavy streaks when I do this. Mm. What does that mean?
It means this. When you when you submerge your brush, your pigment into your brush, right? Mm-hmm. Right now it have color, but remember, if you put on the nails, this gonna get really messy. So you have to knock it off. So right now you have no dust, okay? Still, when you come in here, one stroke, and you take a look at it, because if it's too heavy and just one stroke, that means that's too much color on the brush. So what you do is you take this and you run over the paper towel like this. That will remove it, okay? So when you put it on, it's gonna be much lighter. And if it's not light enough, you do one more repetition. Run it through the paper towel means you're removing the color from the brush. So it can be much lighter, because when it's light, you can do heavy stroke and you'll be fine, because there's not much color in the brush. There's a few tips and tricks that you have to keep in mind. Write it down if possible, because you will forget it later if you don't write it down. Okay, so remember, I'm gonna load my brush. So my brush have colors, okay, but this amount of dust is not doable. So knock it off the table. You just wanna knock the dust off. You knock the dust off, so now it's dust free. That doesn't mean that the color is light, it just means that it's dust free. So if it's heavy on you, the streak is heavy, you remove it by running it through the paper towel. However, I'm working with pastel, so my color is not heavy at all. It's actually perfect. So do mind the white pigment is the most important pigment, and I will have it for sale separately later, because white pigment is heavenly to work with. See how I mix it? Look at the brightness and the softness of the colors. I love the white pigment. When you mix it in colors, it looks like magic. See that? It's like airbrush. See how poppy it is? Okay, now next one. Pink, purple here, pink, green, and then yellow, and then green. See, the purple is translate over here. So purple, and then pink, and then yellow, and then green in the bottom. So it's flip-flop. Hi, Michelle.
So fun fact, Jen says, Viva paper towels do not feel good when you are sick and have to blow your nose. Fast. I think I can actually top that one. They really don't work either at all as good as when you don't watch news ever, and you go and do a class in California and everyone's really being weird because everyone has masks on, and as you approach people to discuss anything, they're jumping back, and it was chaos, and we were out there, what, 3 days? Didn't know. So we stocked up on nothing. We get back, you can't find a roll of toilet paper. You can't find so many
things. I remember
everyone
that.
Everyone was panicking. And
I was like, God, I wish I was stocked up.
It made sense once we knew that COVID was going on. But before that, everything was closed down. I'm beating on doors and stuff. You're looking at me crazy.
And Dustin was freaking out because of the shortage of toilet papers.
Right. So, know this. They're better to blow your nose on than wipe your ass. God, that was great, wasn't it?
Yeah. Only American wipe. Other country, we don't like. We wash.
That's when we wash. You don't have to say it like that.
Well, I don't understand wiping. Well, like if you get some dog poop in your hand, are you just going to wipe it off? And then like, oh, I'm ready to go put lunch. No, you're going to wash it off. I don't understand wiping at all. Like, ew, that's so gross.
Well, it doesn't feel as clean as it used to.
It's so light.
Pigment base, honey.
Ah, it's almost here. It's almost here. Oh, I'm waiting for it too. It's almost here. About a week. I'm very anxiously waiting for Pikmin Days.
What?
It's Pikmin Base. I boot in Pikmin Base.
What did you put like base in Cure?
Have you missed them? Or you haven't used them yet? Yeah, are you black? Are you black already? I'm gonna use other colors.
So we
on the cherry blossom set.
So this is Tino's third live. So he's almost out of. He's almost talking like a man now.
Oh yes, I did two live already today. I did this morning, a live this morning, and then a live on TikTok. I love TikTok, you guys. Oh my God, I love TikTok. It's amazing. You guys have to get TikTok account and watch me on TikTok. It is amazing. I have so much fun on TikTok. I do character painting on TikTok. So I'm thinking no more character painting on Instagram. Because I couldn't make the 1 minute videos. I'm gonna do character painting on TikTok. Instagram, leave for different design, different kind of design. TikTok is like, I think it will be my place for all different characters. Cartoon and Disney and all that.
Oh, I know this too about the pigment is you can dye a...
It's strong,
you guys. Labrador Retriever and a half.
And you gotta know
the jar.
And the color are not inorganic. Like this right here went to a process of electricity to make it neon. But the black pigment, the red pigment, they are actually come from soil and they're organic.
Ooh, organic.
Okay, now let's see. Green right here. Go up to yellow and pink. So purple, and then green and yellow and pink.
That is beautiful already. Well, one thing I loved about TikTok was you get to listen to lots of different music.
Yes. Oh my God. It was so
fun. And we actually weren't even prepared for it.
And then there's all these little gift, like little butterflies and like roses.
Fun things flying on the screen.
Kitty cat and galaxy. Oh my God. That's like.
It's gone.
Yellow.
And then there was little money tips too.
Yes.
And so now
I'm not gonna withdraw it. I'm just gonna use it.
Now we feel like strippers.
Yeah.
And
I feel a little.
Show will be
I feel a little dirty-ish.
You feel dirty?
Yeah.
And we're just gonna build it
up. I make some money on TikTok today through tips, and I feel a little dirty. Okay. I feel like I'm a worker's what do you call it? A public servant.
I feel better being I can't say dancer because we didn't dance.
No.
I got hot halfway through, took my shirt off. But we weren't on screen either, so I didn't think anybody knew it.
Yeah.
So I don't know. The question is,
it made me feel
how
good.
Are we going to give it back? Are we going to give it back to other nail techs? Or?
It made me feel a little dirty in a good way, though.
Dirty in a good way?
Yeah, like a little proud, like dirty and proud.
I do. We should get us a little tip jar.
So I'm just gonna use the money to like tip other artists on Instagram Live.
You know what my favorite little thing was?
What's that? What's that?
The little money shooter.
Yeah.
The little gun that's
green.
Yeah.
Okay, so purple, green, yellow, and pink.
He's going to take whatever was there and then post them on YouTube.
Yes, you guys gonna see. I cannot save it on TikTok, but I can retrieve it to my phone. Right now, it's still downloading as we speak, and I can put it on YouTube. And you guys, the quality is amazing. The quality of TikTok is fantastic. It's crisp. It's sharp.
So this is actually gonna help somebody that's wanting to do YouTube.
They're going to help. This going to be like a YouTube live.
Right. You'll be able to take that here and then put it over here.
Yes.
They'll be able to rewind, play it on big screens.
It's going to be fantastic.
Pretty soon, you'll be in movie theaters.
Ooh.
Ooh. What? Tina on the big screen. There'll be men in the thing with and women, you know, with trench coats on and stuff.
Like Marilyn Monroe. Caught up
like Pee Wee Herman. It's going to be a whole thing. Whole thing.
They get to get kidnapped?
If I do my job right, no.
Oh.
Only by me. Oh, I mean, maybe a small one.
Maybe a small kidnapping.
Small one, just a small one.
A small cellmate kidnapping.
I love you.
That's how I'm going to fake my death, Dustin.
You're going to fake your death?
I make a commitment online. There's people watching me every day. So I could not just like disappear, right? So yeah. I'm going to fake my death at some point.
I think it's going to be extravagant. I'm gonna go with you.
Oh, it's gonna be extravagant. It's gonna be something people never heard before. It's gonna be shocking.
I gotta go with you. It's gotta be a duel. I can't stand in front of the cameras knowing you're alive. I'll still look happy. And then they'll be like, oh, you're happy about his death. And then they'll try to, he must have killed him. You know what I mean? And then how am I gonna get to your island?
Well, by the time that I'm getting 3 tires, I don't know.
We'll be like, there was a plane crash onto a deserted island.
I wouldn't say the plane crash. It could be something more exciting.
Something more exciting?
I'm still planning on it. Still planning on my fake death.
I thought we were just fake dying. I didn't know it had to be extravagant.
It's gotta be. It's an exit.
You know what I'm saying?
It's gotta be like the entrance.
On-screen alien abduction.
It's gotta be like one of the intro.
Alien abduction death. I think that's
gonna be. No, it gotta be glamorous.
That's not glamorous?
No.
How's that not glamorous? We're taking a vote and we all think plane crash is the safest.
Plane crash is so normal. I want it to be on the news for months. Okay. Now I am gonna dust it.
Let me see there. Questions. Here we are having too much fun, honey.
Okay, very carefully dust. Now, I'm gonna use Chrome base.
Hello, Oregon.
But actually, you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna use Chrome base because I'm gonna crump it.
Did you fully cure the pigment base or just 8 seconds?
No.
Pigment base is always 60 seconds.
Always fully cured. 60 seconds is like a cheating strategy with a gel-like matte. But pigment base is built for pigment.
Lindsay knows what she's doing.
Yeah, pigment base built for pigment. Chrome base, so I can chrome this.
Matter of fact, Lindsay has very... Matter of fact, Australia is an awesome...
Because... Oh, Lindsay.
Both are.
Thank you for the color bear. You see the color bear?
You mean the necklace.
Do not use this. Fuck, here's some chrome. Use this chrome base. Now I'm gonna adhere both nails.
Are we going to announce when we do TikTok?
We already did. I'm juggling.
It's not going to be a set schedule yet. We have to go and do the show in Chicago.
Yeah.
And then after that, we'll probably have our brains back on better.
Hear this. Yeah, we don't know for sure on like the specific time and date. I'm thinking, because I'm kind of addicted to TikTok a little bit ish.
Me too.
So.
I think you're addicted to feeling like a whore.
No, so, I didn't ask for the tips. No, I didn't ask for the tip. I was classy. I didn't ask for it. I'm a classy focus. I didn't ask.
No, you mean.
I was just.
You're a beautiful.
I was just giving the eyes. And then that's it.
That's
pretty much it. It's all I take. All right. Now.
Oh, yes. Now that exists, we have to go down in a blinged out helicopter. That'd be beautiful.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
It's gotta be a price number on it too, like front meal, a $200 million helicopter crash, and guess who in it?
Yeah.
One and only Tina Moe. Oh, the cold works morning.
Oh, the cold work morning.
Yes, I'm on an island. I'm trying to make it all and oh, well, you look at that.
with the cat.
Out there in the dark. Okay, now.
Oh, you... and here's how we support ourselves after death. That's when Tino's nail sets will be available. It'd be like,
for sale.
It'd be like, and on the helicopter was this trunk full of Tino's only last nails.
I'd be like, Dustin, what do you think about cashing in for retirement?
And then it'd be like, I've got a pair of authentic Tino signed. So 25,000.
Okay, I'm taking out unicorn chrome. So this is green. I am going to use it.
Oh my God, we've been challenged, honey.
Okay, now.
So, I'm intrigued. How do you guys read my username?
Oh.
I thought it was.
Wait. You go first.
Exlexio.
No, it's Liaso.
Huh?
It's Liaso.
No.
It's Liaso.
It's Lexio.
No, it's Liaso.
It what?
It's Liaso.
I don't get where you're getting this whole.
It's Liaso. You say the whole thing at one. Sisa, Sisha, but the seashore. It's Liaso.
No, don't take it there. Don't do that to me.
I'm just a natural at it.
Oh my God. Marley said, no, the hottest badass kidnapping headline will read World's Greatest Nail Diva. Extraordinary Tino Moe was kidnapped and presumed dead.
Oh, yes.
And we're both on the island. You know, we're doing terrible in that. It's.
Yeah, but because I cannot just say. Okay, hey, everybody. Well, at that point, they're probably like 60 and still hot, you know, because in the nail fashion industry, I have full intention on remain hot despite my despite my age. Just like fashion, how like Chanel, I mean, they're old as heck, but they're still hot. I have full intention on still being hot in the nail fashion industry, even when I'm old. So I'm probably like 60. I couldn't just say, hey, everybody. That's it. It's over. I am going to retire. It's going to break everyone's heart. It's better when I'm dead. Yes. Famously dead. On headline and everything. That way they can feel proud. So totally, they have a few seconds of mourning and then they can actually tell their friend, hey, guess what?
Guess what?
I know Tina Moe. So you want to buy this nail set for $1,000? They're going to put it all on eBay. Oh man, they're gonna make bang off it. Come read it all over eBay.
Okay. Lynn said, I'm still getting through my wet gel. Should I still fully cure that? Because I find it works better after 8 to 10 second cure. When it's finished, I'll get pigment base. You know, remember, Lindsay, you just do it by your light.
Yes.
We say 8 seconds, but if you got a stronger light,
I know what she meant. Okay, this one thing you need to look out for. Because you use your white polish, right? You keep it for 8 seconds. It's work great for you, but remember, it's a gel polish. You have to finish curing it. You have to finish curing it and seeing color and pigment on it, maybe cure twice. Because a polish needs to be complete cure or else it can cause problem, longevity problems.
Okay.
So just finish curing it. After you apply pigment, finish curing it. Yes, I'm glad you asked that question.
And we apologize for being neglectful.
Okay, now it's time for me to do math so I can use my clear textures. So what I do is I am gonna make embossed pattern on my clear texture gels.
Honey, let's get back to this. I still
matted.
So back to Exlexia. So what's happened now is, I hate this because they think they've made it simple for us and by somehow spreading it out. But I still,
let me see.
I'm still lost on the
let me see.
So it's
It's Lee. Oh,
I don't know.
It's Leah. It's Leah. It's O.
You think it's Leah? Okay, Leah. Now this is what I want to know. Is Leah. It? I think it's Leia, like Princess Leia from.
That's what I say. You make fun of
no,
me.
No, you said Leah.
No, I say Leia. Okay. So I say Leia. All like three sound at once, like a pro. Leia.
Leia. It's Leia. Okay. Yes, it's Leia. I still think you said.
It's Leia.
Tino, do you know Mino Bo, a nail artist from the UK?
Mino? I think I saw Mino. I think I saw that name before. I know that name. Mino Bo, I know that
name. Wait. Remember, I used to call you Mino back in the days when you were Mino.
When I'm fine.
Back in the days when you were dealing with those bitches and had no zero tolerance. And
I have no zero tolerance. Baby. I have no zero tolerance on cancel appointment or even like no car, no show is definitely non-acceptable. But appointment get canceled, even the day before, it's a little like uncomfortable for me. And then late, so I'm just kind of mean. I don't tolerate. At all.
So why does mine want to be good at chrome? Mine gets all glittery on the top coat.
Okay, so when your chrome get glittery, you need to check three things.
Oh, it is weird.
You need to check three things. Two of the first thing is product related. First thing is a base. Are you chrome base? I trust it 100%. Are you chrome base? If you choose alternative product, you have to check to see if the product you use is good or not good.
Did you say alternative or inferior?
Alternative product, other product. Now, number two is the chrome itself. The chrome itself, I use solid chrome. And I will tell you the reason why. So number two, you need to check your chrome. Definitely don't want to buy cheap chrome because there are quality chrome and there are cheap chrome. The reason why I use my solid chrome, I'm not saying that you have to use solid chrome, you can use loose chrome too. But the reason why I use solid chrome because solid chrome is pressed, the particle is fine. When the particle is fine, less likely that it will cut loose and flow up to the surface when you top coat it. However, especially loose chrome, it may look smooth and fine because it's dry. Of course, it's gonna be shiny and smooth. But if those flake and particle doesn't stick on the nail well, which big particle is harder for it to stick. You rub chrome on, it look nice and shiny. The moment you put top coat on, all that particle will flow up to the surface and it will make it glittery.
All is left over.
Yeah, you extra. Need to check your chrome. To make sure it's quality chrome.
That makes sense.
Number three is essential. Number three is after you check your product, your chrome, you have to make sure your chrome is dust truly. Because sometimes the excess dirt that are left on the surface, we don't see it. Because it's nice and shiny. We don't see a few excess dust. But when you put a top coat on, by all means you will see it. It will flow up to the surface.
And then too, probably. No, that makes a lot of sense.
All right, now.
I hope that helped. And then as far as what chrome do you use?
Solid chrome. I use solid chrome. And I have a few powder chrome that you can mix to make cat eyes. It's all in the color category, in chrome category. I have a full category for just chrome.
What number of prime is the one you use? So it's fourth degree, no. What number of chrome? Not chrome.
Oh, the chrome that I just used is green unicorn chrome. So unicorn chrome, I have five colors. they're responsible to show the background. Different than solid chrome, unicorn chrome doesn't care what color it's gonna show. Versus solid chrome, it's gonna hide the color. So unicorn chrome on I use for the base. Now you're gonna see it as well because I just matted. So you don't see it as well. But the reason why I matted, because I am gonna use this clear texture gels right here. And I am gonna make my unicorn pattern.
When will Fairy Gel Pack be in stock?
Fairy Gel is out of stock?
I think they want a bundle.
Oh, the bundle. I'll let them know. Oh, I got it. It'd be good. We have to bring some for the show in Chicago's. Oh, Fairy Gel, I just make order last month. It's gonna be in stock soon. I forgot. I make order last month on Fairy Gel. So I already make refill. It's coming. It should come in like any day now. So if you wonder how I can do this line really, really close together and not having them fused together, you have to have a gel where it's on cell level like this. See that? This is clear texture effect. I call it texture effect because I use it to make textures. I can carve in it and the carve, it will remain there.
Was the rainbow part done with gel?
It's done with pigment and pigment base. This nail set will pack you with most of the technique that can make you a lot of money in salon because they're a trendy technique. You can break it apart. We already went through the pigment part. Blending green airbrush effect is highly desirable now today. So you learned that. Chrome, that's not really a technique in my eyes, but whatever. You learn how to use unicorn chrome over rainbow color. Yeah, yeah. It's sort of a technique, but you have to use it. The purpose of me using unicorn chrome is I have a nice rainbow background. So I use unicorn chrome so I can still see the rainbow background, but now I also have chromey effect too. So that's a purpose of me using chrome. But the third thing is emboss like this, using proper gel to emboss.
And I think that girl, that lady you like, Christy Meekins in here.
Hi, Christy's. Oh, where is Christy? Oh, let me find her. Oh, Christy Meekins. Where is it?
Do you have...
I miss her.
Do you have a stained glass bundle? If not, will you?
I do. I have a stained glass bundle. Yes. It's in the bottom of the category. Go to stained glass and scroll to all the color and it's down the bottom. That's bundle. Okay. I bump into a little bit of something here. Have to make sure I end it nicely. Wanna look funny. Yes! Oh, I made it. Now I'm just gonna go back and refine whatever it is that I need to refine to make sure. If you want to work this line to what they close together, you can.
Okay, I've decided it's Viv-Riv.
Viv-Riv?
Anyway, Viv-Riv65 says, I love this design that you're doing, and I love your work. Just don't get enough of you.
Oh, thank you, Viv-Riv. Okay. Focus a little bit because I'm doing it way on top.
There she is,
Annie. She's me balance.
Chris, she says, I love this already.
Ah, thank you, Christy. Oh. Oh my God, I wish I can hang out with you one day in UK. Oh my God, it's gonna be crazy. Mm. Christy is so fun. You ever watch a YouTube? Christy is fun. Christy is crazy like me.
I think so.
Oh man, I love Christy.
Looking at the picture, she looks like
she's
a lot of fun.
Oh yeah, quite a personality, an amazing personality. I know her forever, a long time. I know her when I was a nobody. I know her.
Oh, baby, you've never been a nobody.
I watch her on YouTube all the time. I love her. Okay, I'm gonna do this just to clean the shape up.
Uh-oh, Kirsty. Holy shit. See, you are listening
to me. Oh, my God.
You must know I don't read.
You know what? I'm just going to decide that it's Kirsty. Since I know it's for so long, it's going to be Kirsty.
No. No, I like Kirsty better.
Yeah, this. Oh, you make fun of my accent.
Kirsty's easy. It is.
Okay, let me see. Okay, now I'm gonna make a C-sap. So, let me see how I'm gonna operate this. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna get an upside down seashell.
Ooh, a Tino and Kirsty live, that would be great.
Oh, hell yes.
So what platform would you two like to get kicked off together?
Today, Instagram have to. Hold on, let me see. Becky, can you turn your hand over for me, please? Thank you. Anyway, so today on Instagram, people have to remind me of what try to behave because they can kick you off TikTok. You mean TikTok?
We've been kicked out of better places.
So I like, oh, I have to behave now. Fine, whatever. So well, I don't know about TikTok.
We won't actually know any rules that are broke.
Oh, you too.
Do it and they warn us. So the good news is. We'll be warned and sanctioned for a minute, but we'll learn our lesson the hard way.
Yeah.
As we always would do.
I always try them. I always do.
Not on purpose. Not on purpose.
I'm a fire sign.
We're firm believers in asking for apologies as opposed to permission.
Yes. Okay.
Kirsty said that'd be fun and a great idea.
For TikTok or YouTube? I think
I don't
YouTube.
Know.
YouTube.
I don't know anything.
Man,
about
oh my God. That. I'm kind of shaky right now.
You kind of shaky?
I'm
excited.
I'm excited. Okay. Get me balance.
You're going to be all giddy and shaky, honey. then what you need to do is marble.
Yeah, you know what? I tell people, you know what? When you do a line work, if you're shaky, you should do a marble. There's no way that I can completely focus. With Christy, I'm going to have so much fun. I'm going to do all marble. I'm going to do like a marble design. Okay, let me see. All right. An upside down pattern. I didn't do that last
year. What gel is that, baby?
This is a clear texture gel, so it's non cell level. You can draw as close as possible. It's not gonna budge at all.
She said your work is incredible.
Thank you.
Hello, Jamie.
I love nails. I love nail art. That's something that I'm proud of.
Very passionate.
It's because I try to live out in the woods before. I'm discovered that I'm helpless at everything else in life. I couldn't catch a deer. Every time I see a deer, I giggles. So all the guys will ban me off the trip. They say, you're not allowed to come with us because you giggle and a deer run away. So I couldn't hunt. So the fish doesn't bite my bait ever. Something about me that it doesn't like. So I couldn't fish, I couldn't hunt, I couldn't do anything. I can only do nails. So I better make the best of it.
And I also decided that's probably, you could cook the food most.
I can cook very good, yes. Yes.
And I didn't like to run around with a gun either.
Yeah.
Creepy.
I get crazy when I have the power of murder in my hand. I get crazy.
Hello, Justoria. So we had a question. I got to find.
Okay.
You
know what? I'm gonna go for everything.
What are the pigments on the website called?
Super pigment.
Super pigment.
Super pigment. Uh-huh. It's in the color category and it's in these pigment category. I'm gonna go over all of it. I had it. I never done anything like this. I mean, I done something like this, but I never done like all over. So I'm just gonna do it all over.
All over.
I'm gonna go crazy. See, I got a little Kirsty vibe in me now. I'm gonna go absolutely crazy.
Okay, so the Kia nails said, how long have you been doing Tino? I think they meant doing nails.
Oh.
So the answer is, you've been doing nails for 14 years. I've been doing Tino, if that's what it was, for about nine.
For about nine.
So I don't know which one, but there's both answers.
I've been doing nails for 14 years, but I'm always 21. I'm always 21. I was 21 last year. Yes. So when I was started doing nail, I was close to 21. But after my 21 birthday last year, I just have December gonna be my next 21 birthday.
December's gonna be your next 21 birthday.
Yeah, it just passed.
And you know, Jenna can get $15 for her birthday thing. Surely we can get,
I know, right?
20, right?
What in the world?
You will be having a birthday ticket, a party.
My friend Jenny having her birthday. And she said, Tino, come over for my birthday. I couldn't go, but I just found out today that Jenny charge people. You have to buy a ticket to come to her birthday party. Oh my god. I don't know why it's funny, but it is.
Will texture gel come off clients that are rough on their nails?
If you apply too thick, they can puncture it. If you like too thick. If texture gel, this texture gel, no way. This texture gel, it will not come off. It will not, you have to like fire it up. But if you use a black texture gel, let me show you. This black texture gel is what I use to make leathers with. You have two options. After you engrave your textures, you apply chrome and top coat. The first option, though, a more risky option, is after you apply engrave and cure, you can leave it without top coat to maintain the leather look on it. However, when you applied it and not plan to top coat it, you have to be exceptionally aware of the viscosity on it, of the amount of gel on it, because if it's too thick, then it's not going to be cured properly in the bottoms. So make sure that if you texture gels, if you choose the option to not top coat in it, meaning no chrome, you have to be careful how much you apply so it's not too thick. But this texture gel is built for thickness. Clear texture gel that I'm using, you can build a house on top of the nails. Oh. And your client will have a hard time taking it up or peeling it up even. I mean, you can make a bet with them. That's what I did to my client like years ago. I make a bet. If they ever afraid, like they'd be like, oh, can I grab it up? You say, how much you want to bet? Make a bet with them. I bet $10. The last person, Amber was asking how I'm going to take, when I put on that jam, that bowl jam,
yes,
like that kind
yes.
of come off. And I said, it's not going to come off. And she said, it's going to come off. So I say, $10. Want a bet? I won $10.
Mm-hmm. And she was trying hard.
She was trying to take it out. She was trying.
I'm like, well, you're going to rip your nail off.
I'm going to see about opal gel, about green opal gel. I want to see how it looks. I'm going to do green opal gel. But first, I want to top coat it because I'm not sure if it go with my team. So fucking first. Chew some top coat. Chew matte so we can see things easily. I want to make sure, because if it doesn't look good, then I'm going to choose alternative option, which is unicorn clips. I don't know if the flaky looks good in here. I'm going to put a crystal right in the middle. Look at that, you guys. Hypnotizing. Okay, now let's see. So green opal gel is flake. It's not glitter, it's flakes. And it's like a lip gel, but it's like a see-through lip gel. So like Spark is also a lip gel, but it's solid and it's fine. This flake is not really fine. There is some chunky flake on there. They are very thin. I wanna have it to make my opal look. This year, I am gonna make another opal look, and this time it's gonna be fire because I'm having an actual opal flake. But first, I'm gonna apply a layer of green opal on here, just to check it out to see how it looks with this cream. Okay, one scoop. And here I go. Oh my god. Yes. Yes. It looks good. Let's do it all on the index and on the pinky.
You're addicted now.
No, I wasn't addicted. See my face? I'm being cool.
You're being cool.
No.
Oh my god.
You're addicted.
Okay.
It looks even better from above.
Oh, it's look good. Okay, now I am gonna clean the side. Mm-hmm. Opal gel have a creamy light textures.
Hello, Tara.
Hi, Tara. It's back to you. Flat brush to stroke it.
Do you know who Tara is, or did you just say that?
I say that because you say that.
I love you.
I don't look.
Hello,
at
Dark Tiger.
Ooh, Dark Tigers.
No, he's been following me forever.
Yeah?
Yeah. But Tara is the Angel Nail Tech, your super stalker. Remember?
Okay.
I had to get her name.
You gotta get all the stalker down because I need to know all my stalker.
Stalkers are understandable. Super stalker. The one that knew some shit from like 7 years ago, I was like, oh my god.
I have a very special relationship with my stalkers. So I love all my stalkers.
Address.
But if I catch you stalking me, I'm gonna pretend that I hate it. I'm gonna be like, ugh. But just know the inside, I love and appreciate you stalking me. But then I'm pretend that I'm gonna be repulsed by it.
Seems like even a small kidnapping might be acceptable. I don't know what the difference is between a small kidnapping and a big one. But...
Let's not tell people how to kidnap me, because there is a code and there is safe word. And there's safe word and everything. And if you're not a professional at kidnapping me, I'm going to freak out. Hear this. Don't do it.
So only...
Leave it for the one that already... Yeah, the professionals. I'm going to leave this here. I am going to do something else to this. I am going to put top coat to this. So if you want to make it high gloss and you want to apply top coat into it, this is how you're going to do it. You're not just going to slap top coat on this. No. You want the texture to be there. So I am going to take a paper towel and some Aston, and I am going to rub on it just to make sure that it take a little bit of the shine left, the shine. It will wear up in about a week and a half, 2 weeks, and it will become this. So it's kind of like a polish, basically. So if you leave it without top coat, there is no wipe. So at first it will look like this, and 2 weeks later it will look like this. It's still going to be shiny, but if you want high gloss, then this is how you apply it with shine it. So I am gonna rub on these two now with Aston. And I am gonna take Shandit out and make sure that not there's not really any gel on Shandit. So I make sure I clean the bottle thoroughly, so there's no gel dripping.
Thoroughly.
Yeah. Thoroughly.
Thoroughly.
So there's no gel dripping anywhere.
We should just say good. Pretty good.
Yeah.
Question.
And I just touching it. Just touch on it. Yeah,
does
go ahead.
The glitter coat self-level?
Glitter coat? If you stroke it, it'll be smooth. But if you twirl it around, it'll be very slow for it to be smooth again. I only use that to make a hole now or stroking it. If you use, like, let's say you draw like a flower or something and you want like a little opal on the side, normally I will use Aurora gels or Diamond Flash. But however, if you want to put a little opal out on just like just a spot, then make sure that you stroke it thin.
Oh,
so this is how you replace the non-white coat of clear texture with the shanded. You just keep the gel on your brush minimal and you just touching it like this. Or, I don't know why I do it this way, instead of taking shanded out and then using a filler brush, a filler brush right here. Maybe I use it just to show you guys the inconvenience. I was just talking and I wasn't paying attention. Okay, so with a filler brush, I would soak it into the brush. Okay, make sure that's not a lot. And then you just replace it like this. See that? All over. There you go. Okay, so that is your choice. I have a little lot of gel right here. I need to clean this up. Here this. On clients that are not too damaging on their nail, they're not like crazily active, I normally would just leave the no white surface and just not top coat it. But in a client that washing the hand, like nurses or like a waitress, I don't know why a waitress would go get a luxury nails set, but if they waitress, they wash it a lot with dish chemical and all that. So it's harsh on their nail. So you can replace that coat with a coat of shanded to ensure that it's long lasting, because shanded don't fade at all. Shanded doesn't scratch. Like people that bump their nail a lot, they might have scratches on the surface. Tiny scratches that you cannot see, but it affects the shine. And which shined it is scratch proof. And opal gel, sorry, I jump back and forth. Opal gel, one thing that I'm gonna use it for that required to be non-cell level. It's not completely non-cell level, but I'm gonna use it.
You're out of frame, baby.
Oh, sorry. I'm gonna use it for making gemstone later on by establishing a background and then you over gel as a volume on it for gemstone and crystal making. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about? Like resin, pendant, stuff like that.
Honey, can you hear me crunching? I'm trying to quietly eat over here, but I've just got hungry.
So that is a demonstration of making this high gloss just for you to see, so you can choose do whatever. Opal gel right here is also no white. Okay, so you can leave it just like that, but again, if you want, you will shine it on. You don't have to wipe it up. Let's see. Let's wipe it up just to see.
Hey, goodie, Matt's here.
Hi, Matt.
So, question, Matt.
Ask them.
What did you do?
Oh, yeah, I want to know. I want to know so I don't violate. I heard. So I don't violate TikTok. I just do a TikTok live today. I wasn't really top code this well. So I erase it a little bit. That's fine. I just use fairy gel to fix it. Yeah, I heard that you get kicked out of TikTok's live. I want to know why, so I don't violate the rules.
Honey, quick question.
Yes.
When you stipulate my foil flower, and then encapsulated the foil after I top coated the foil, my client says the acrylic came off.
The acrylic came off?
I don't know why we put acrylic on.
Okay, read that again. I need to absorb it.
I use sticky.
Okay.
To like foil flowers. And then encapsulated the foil after I coated the foil.
Oof. Oh my God. Okay. Okay. So let me tell you the first thing first. Mm-hmm. I don't recommend using acrylic on top of gel. Now, I used to do it back in the old day. It's one of my cheap way. Because back in the old day, either you design on top of nails or you do acrylic design. I do both. So I do gels and then I put acrylic on it too. Sometimes I have that problem. Not every time, but sometimes, just with certain clients, it's a hit and miss. But I don't recommend putting gel on top of a nail. I recommend prep the nail well, primer, have a tip. So everything on it, the nail bed, the acrylic can adhere to, and the tip is made out of plastic, so the acrylic can adhere to. Now, with gel, sometimes gel have a hard consistency that acetone cannot penetrate to it. Anytime that happens, acrylic will have problem penetrating the gel. However, sticky I use is to, if you like the level of stick that it does, it ensure that it lay flat on the surface, the flower, so you can top coat it. Or maybe if it's too bumpy, then you can put a thin layer of 3D jelly on it. So sticky is used for surfacing. Now, if you choose to encapsulate it, your flower already with acrylic, you don't need to go through all that sticky, the gel and all that. People that encapsulate flower in acrylic, you put a little dot of acrylic, just a thin dot, you lay the flower down, some glitters, and then you go ahead and encapsulate it with acrylic. You don't need specialty gel. The reason why I use sticky with flowers is I want to demonstrate it, that people gone through so much with acrylic, right? They have to put a dry flower on, they have to put acrylic on, they have to file and shape. I want to demonstrate that there is another way. You can use sticky on a surface like this.
Right.
Press flower on. You either just top coat it or 3D jelly on it. Right. So now, if you use in gel and you do acrylic, number one, I don't recommend using acrylic on gel. But number two, it's unnecessary.
Right.
Because back in the day, when I don't have sticky and I have to use acrylic, I either use a dot of acrylic and put on like flower, or I just use glue. I put some glue on. Put some flour on so I can press it. Because with acrylic, sometimes people try to press and acrylic is still premature. It don't adhere. But glue, you can press the pedal on the left and then you can put some glue on the right and you can press the pedal on the right. By the time you're done with the glue, the flour is laying flat on the surface and you put acrylic on. I hope that answers your question and confusion. Is that too much information?
No, it was perfect, actually.
Okay, good.
I feel like, but I understood her things. I've seen the whole process here, so we have to ask her. Did that answer your question?
Hopefully. Yes. Here it is. Yeah, back in the day when I have that problem, am I back off from that strategy? No, not really. I don't back up from that strategy using acrylic over gel. What I do is I aware of it. So let's say this is a nail tip, right? I glue it on my natural nail. When I apply gels, instead of applying all over, because that's gonna cover the edge and everything, and then you lay the acrylic on. So acrylic just laying on top of gel, really. What I do is I put a little gel, whatever gel I want, onto the nail surface, but I leave the edge.
Right.
So when I put the acrylic on, even if the acrylic could not adhere to my gel, it adhere to the edge.
It has something to grab onto.
There's no way that it come out. A little trick still, I don't recommend it still, but if you must, there is trick for it.
Tricks. That's why you got tips on TikTok.
Tanya say I'm dying to recreate this set.
Okay, you had another question up here.
Go ahead.
That sounded like a brain teaser. Let me see. How about when using alcohol inks?
Yes.
White base, then matte, then alcohol ink, design, then clear top coat. I wore it and it started to peel up. Any pointers?
Repeat.
When using alcohol ink.
Alcohol ink.
White base. Then matte.
Then matte.
Then alcohol ink.
Wait. White base. Then matte. That's right. And then alcohol ink.
Then the alcohol ink design.
Okay.
Then clear top coat.
Clear top coat.
Mm-hmm.
And it come off.
And then at that point, she took off and wore it, and then it came off.
Okay. So I need to know a few things. So when it came off, there is several reasons. So when you put the white base on, it should be good. When you put the matte on, it should be good. Now, when you put the alcohol ink on, that could be a problem right there if it's too wet. And then top coat can be also be a problem. Okay. So if the top coat chip and the ink is still there, then that's the top coat.
Okay.
If it chip and you see white, you don't see the ink anymore, top coat and the ink chip, the ink is too wet. Let it dry a little bit more.
So really you have to see which layer came off and was affected.
Right. But what I know is not affected is the white base. Have nothing to do with the white base. The matte, it have nothing to do with the matte. Because it chip up, but if it chip up, the white chip up too. Got if it. She had a marble nail set and then suddenly it chip up, but she sees the natural nail underneath or the acrylic underneath, that means your white have problems.
Your white?
The white base have a problems, right? So a strict matter of how it chips, but some of the layer have a problems.
She said, yes, see white.
See white, the ink, make sure you dry a little bit. Are you Aston to inkify it? Because Aston evaporate fast. Now, if you alcohol, you want to dry a little bit. Alcohol take longer to completely evaporate off the surface. Before she apply top coat, when she apply top coat, again, I will go through it one more time. If your ink is just like a little bit right here, then sure, top coat, whatever you like. However, if your ink is all over the nail, you got to know that it can cover the edge and everything. So now we have to question, okay, what the ink is made out of, what kind of pigment it is. Because if the top coat cannot stick to those kind of pigment of the ink, what happened if your ink is all over the nail and you put top coat on, it just laying on top of the ink.
She said the top coat took the alcohol ink with it. Then the white nail remains.
That's the ink. That's the ink. So I show you a few things. So if your ink is all over the nail like this, you let it dry, and when you top coat, you have to cap the edge. You treat it like a chrome. Okay, another tricks, but this one is semi-dangerous. Sticky, where are you? Sticky. I use sticky to adhere chrome and any material that are foreign to the nail. For example, I have a layer of chrome on. Before I put top coat on, if that client is high maintenance or difficult, then I apply sticky to the chrome surface. Now you cannot keep playing with it. You have to apply about 2 or 3 strokes. That's it, on one spot. So I stroke it through the nails. I cured it, and then I apply top coat on. You can use the same tactic on the ink. Make sure it's dry. Apply sticky on, but I wouldn't play with it too much. You don't want to bleed it.
She said, thank you. She got you.
This set right here, even though I'm done with designing, I have your black crystal in front of you because the beauty of this set is from the colors. So it's texture, it's from the color. I have to have crystal on so you can see the vision behind it.
Oh.
Yes.
I just remember at the beginning you want, was it dreamy unicorn?
I want it to be dreamy.
Oh, I ain't drinking no water or nothing for a while.
Okay, so now I take out what I need for my crystals. First is glue. Thank you. I have glue, I have glue dryer, just in case, texture gel, just in case. They work for beading. Crystal katana out by the Crystal Ninjas. Crystal sealer out, just in case I want to seal it. And lana brush, so I can work with bead. Make sure to wipe all the gel off it. Lana brush right here. I need a palette just for gel material and all that. I put it on a palette. And what else I'm missing? What I'm missing? Katana. I think that's it. All right. Now, I am going to get some AB crystal. And then some AB stone. I am gonna use Crystal Paradise Shine.
Crystal Paradise?
Yes. This is Crystal Paradise Shine. It's what I'm gonna use. It's purple and lavenders and golden tone. One of my absolute favorite. So I am gonna use Crystal Paradise Shine with Aurora Arbolis Stone. This Aurora Arbolis AB, similar tone, blue and pink. All right, and my palette that I use, I have the side just for glue. See that side? I was putting in gel right here, but this side I use just for glue. Because sometimes even if I wipe it off, there's some residue on it. And when I'm in a hurry, I'm not gonna try to like peel it all off. So I'm just gonna use this side only for glue.
This side.
This side. All right, now our first victim is this finger right here. Mm-hmm. Let's see what stone it is for. Oh, by the way, you guys, even though this is pretty and I want to use it, Dreamtime crystal doesn't make it anymore. It has to be a special order, so I am slowly bringing this shape back, okay. I mean, you can find this shape on like a Preciosa or like Spark or whatever other brand, but the nice brand, the ones from Austria, doesn't make it anymore. You have to put in special orders. So
how dare you show us some shit we can't have?
I just want to tease you a little bit. Let me see. I want to use this shape right here. One of my favorite shapes too. Mainly because back then when I still using gel, it's a harder shape that adheres and seal because of the round two side. But since the day I have the glue, then I'm really, really like this shape. I use it all the time.
The teardrop?
Yes, a teardrop. It's not a teardrop. It's like a 2-point. It's have a name.
I think I'm a
woman, I have to track down the name to know what it's called. I bet Cindy know.
It's me, honey.
Feel so bad because
I
should have the kit available already. The bling kit, but I still haven't.
You know what, we're gonna get better.
I still haven't get onto it, you guys.
You know, we'll just look at them like you're helping them. They're all crystal addicts.
Oh my god, yes, I am so gonna do this. Like this. Just like this. Mm. I want to make sure that this is not in my way. So what I would do is I would kind of balance it out. Not with gel, but with a top coat. I'm going to balance it out with top coat.
Balance with top coat.
Yeah, because the surface is bumpy. I'm not going to stick a crystal on that. Doesn't matter how good the glue is. If the surface is bumpy, the crystal is not going to be stabilized. Kia this.
They think it might be called flame.
No.
What are you trying to get? The color name or the shape?
Yeah, give me the shape, the name. Flame is alternative brand. It's not a nice brand. It's probably pre-sale style, Spark or any one of that. I'm talking about the brand. You know what I'm talking about. The one from Austria. If we have a sample, I will show you the number of it. I think it's 2058. I think that is the name of the shape. They have so many shapes that they have the wood number on it. Okay, so I'm gonna apply glue. 2058, I believe that is the name of the shape. Good. See that? Now I'm gonna try it. Touch it a little bit.
Babe, I don't know where I put it.
Oh, that's fine, that's fine. I'll have a clean kit later. It's easier for me to have a kit.
Yeah.
So I put on the website, so there's no need to track down the name of the stone.
We'll get it all figured out.
Got it.
When I say we, I mean you.
Well, the website for crystals is on Dreamtime Creation. DreamtimeCreation.com. It's easier to shoot a message to Cindy about this shape. People like this shape, right?
Uh-huh.
Let me ask Cindy. Give me an iPad.
Oh, you guys got Tim pulling some.
I'll ask Cindy right away. She answer me. Another stone right here. Okay. And add it, zoom in. I'm gonna send it to Cindy and say our live audience wanna know what the name of the shape. Oh, our phone doesn't have service.
What's an iPad?
Anyway, I will track down the name and I will post it on the caption of the live. I'm going to save the live, so I'm going to put on the caption for it. All right, let's move on to this.
It's a good idea.
Yeah, I put on the caption for you later on the name of the stone. Ooh. Maybe I should do something with this. I'm gonna have a little stone right here. This is SS16 Paradise Shine.
SS16.
Mm-hmm. Paradise Shine.
Paradise
There you go, Parashai. All right. So let's see what do I do with this crazy bedazzle up here. I do this so it's not bumpy for me to operate on top of this.
To operate?
Yeah. Care this. It's very important. Now these two are definitely need some crystals. But I'm start with Paradise Shine, a cuticle line of Paradise Shine. Using SS16 first, 1, 2. Using bullion B, I'm gonna use silvers. 1, 2. Caviar, I'm sorry. Caviar.
Those are bright.
Bullion are different.
He said, thank you, my love, for teaching you. Nice work, I love you.
You're welcome. Now.
Man, those are bright.
Thank you.
Yeah, we gotta start thinking about, we gotta get busy this week.
Yes.
Whee!
Showtime are coming. Mm-hmm. It gets too normal now that I don't even nervous or get into a... I'm just like, when's the date? I'll show up. Tell me the date. When I first started doing beauty show, oh my God, I was so nervous. I was like, what am I gonna expect? Oh, I was so nervous, but now I like, ugh.
But every single time, maybe you did perfect.
Yeah. I gotta be sexy. I gotta get on a diet. I gotta be sexy for the show.
Maybe you're always.
Yeah.
Ooh, they may be vector shapes. We'll find out.
Not a clue right here. So I'm starting with cuticle line. It may just be the cuticle line, but it may be something else. I'm touching it. I should have dried this before I let it go. Time for me to dry this. There you go. Cannot let it run anywhere.
Nicole says your booth is always lit.
Thank you, Nicole.
He does a fantastic job. They just don't realize you're actually not sociable.
Yeah. I want to lose some weight, though, so I can put on a sexy outfit. If not, I'm just going to wear a big hat.
A big hat?
Yeah, the bigger my hat is, the more insecure about my weight. If I wear a really big, big hat, then you know.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, so watch out for the hat. If I wear no hat, oh, man, that's a good day.
I love you.
I know, right? Nicole says, oh my God, you look great. Stop it. You're always adorable. He sleeps with a beautiful smile on his face. It's a damn thing.
I just really enjoy life all the time.
We're blessed. We may go on live while we are at the show, but that means there'll have to be a dry time, and I'll be the guy on the phone camera, and that usually doesn't turn out good for long.
Let's chew like a teardrop shape. Should I chew like a big one?
How long will crystals last? Mine is always lost just two days.
No, you have to guarantee to your client that it will last until it's until you come back. It's too big.
They're not putting it on right.
Yeah, no. It's not supposed to come up at all. It's supposed to stay always until your client come back. That's how you can charge for it. It's not supposed to have a live shell. Okay, I am gonna add glue and then B.
Okay, that sounded. What are you doing?
Okay, this is heavy, so I gotta make sure I have my glue dryer ready. Okay, now, let's see, I need to add some B. Let's see one right here and one in here. There you go. Perfect. Let's see. You can have something else too. I'm just gonna wait. I'm just gonna do this one and then I'm gonna see what else do is need. Okay. Make sure you generate with your glue. You don't have to apply it wide, but you can apply it high. Don't have to be wide, just high, so that'll be enough glue.
You just have to be high.
Yeah. Like when you apply glue, most people spread it out. I don't spread it out, but I have like one dot, and then I have a glue on top of that one dot. Make it stack it up high.
That was a real good example. I think you see it smooch out.
Yeah, you can see it smooch out.
And then you know it's solid on the backside. Yeah. That's all it's happening is there like an air bubble or a hole or something or an edge.
Right. Rule number one is it have to adhere on a flat surface, you know, semi-flat. But it cannot just hang on and like this is a surface and there is a ledge. You cannot let it balance on the ledge like that. And right. Hopefully that this, the glue will stuck under it. No, it have to be flat and the back of the stone be flat.
But when it's like that, It's hard to get off.
With pointy back, that is a different method for pointy back stone.
When we were testing the glue, oh my goodness, I was for sure as rough as I am, they were going to fly off. Mm-hmm. By the end of it, it was obnoxious. I was doing everything with them, trying to break them off.
Let me see. Okay, let's give it one more. Give another one. Now, on a background like this, see a shiny background? Okay. I am going to go ahead and put some top coat after I'm done.
You know what? You're on the screen.
Yes.
I forgot to plug this one in.
Oh my God, yes.
Oh, go ahead.
That is 4% on my phone right now.
Oh. Ooh.
Okay. Sorry, guy. Right now, I already charged it. Okay.
We'll have the other one on shortly. Thank you, yes. Aunt Deb.
Tomorrow, I will post my first TikTok live on YouTube. That will be something that you will be totally enjoy because the quality is amazing.
Okay, so the tool he is using to apply the stones is a crystal katana.
Yes, this crystal katana is made by the crystal ninja, Kelly the Free.
And then Luscious Ladies Nail says, only blue, pink, and white opal gel on the side. No green?
Oh.
Green will be added.
No, it is my fault. It is my fault. I haven't updated the green yet. I will. Tonight. I will tonight. I'll take a picture tonight. That's my bad. I take pictures tonight. I send it to Cindy. She put it on tomorrow. Make sure I don't forget Dustin. It'll be quick.
Okay.
Snap a picture. Yeah. All right. Now I'm gonna dry it in the glue dryer. See, I need these color stone with this background color. That's what I need. You see the beauty?
You wanna try to...
To what?
Connect yourself again.
Oh, yes, yes. Hi. Okay. Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
The adorable thing was that.
Okay, let's see. So right now, I need to worry about this corner. I'm thinking, should I go elegant or I'm going to make it super gaudy? Super gaudy would distract the detail from here. I'm thinking elegant. Just a crescent moon right here. So this is going to be done in Crystal Paradise Shine.
Matt said he's been super busy.
Hi, that's good.
Well, I thought
yeah, he's trying
to duck and dive, just looking at things after dinner. If he doesn't know, we don't want to do it. We'll be showing up there with forks in our hand.
I know. You're going to spy on him. Do we know where he lives for real?
Huh?
Do we know where he lives for real?
No.
Oh, gosh.
But we can find him.
Actually, it needs to be smallest.
Oh, yeah. So what happened on TikTok? Why'd you get kicked off?
Oh, yeah. I need to know all the rules. Like.
What... No, we don't need to know all of them.
Like,
just
that. How am I not gonna get kicked up? Cause I know I'm risky.
You know that we speak freely too much sometimes.
I know I'm risky.
It's not risky, we're just us, and sometimes that's not politically correct or something. I don't know. No, he's not selling those.
Actually, is that like a glue here? Oh, I didn't put any glue here.
You're amazing. I love watching your videos.
Thank you.
It's awesome.
Thank you. Okay. So I'm bead right here, in here. And some bead in here. Some bead too. Right here. Good, good. All right. Just a small one in here. Good. Now, let's add some down here too.
What do they say? We can't say. Oh, just don't be hateful. Well, we're good at not doing that kind of stuff.
Be what?
Don't be hateful, don't...
Oh, no, I'm not going to be hateful, but I just... Like, you're not supposed to curse money.
You said, like, cursing.
No cursing.
Branding. Don't let your subscribers say provocative words or violence. What's provocative?
Provocative, like, bite me or fondle me.
See, I was afraid that provocative somehow... was intertwined with sexy, and I don't know.
How right, gonna... but no, but I learned today you're not supposed to discuss money, like pricing or whatever. You're not supposed to talk about Instagram while you're on TikTok.
Like we're doing now?
Like I'm doing now. Like I'm doing with it. But I know Instagram, we're cool.
Oh,
me,
you know
me and Instagram are cool.
They love it. They love you there.
Yeah. It's okay. But I don't know TikTok.
Well, us, it wouldn't be the end of the world. We look at it as a sign and roll with it.
There is something else I can do with this.
I feel like you're addicted right now to that because
that is something else.
More?
A beat right here. Yeah, I need some beat right in the meadows up these stones. So maybe one right here. You know what? I have to learn a chair for beat. Why am I using the katana? This is ridiculous. There you go. Gosh, there you go. I have a lana gel for it. I don't know why I'm using the katana. There you go. All right, let's see. Okay. Let me see. What's it look like on here? Ooh.
So, the question is if we get put in jail, they let us bond out. Are we going to be able to?
If we in jail, there will be 480,000 people that will bond Tino out because they need the life.
They need the life.
They need the life to keep on going. They will bond Tino out. All 400,000 people, all over the world. La 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 la, it's getting pretty. Make sure I put a lot of glue.
I'm probably eating this whole charcuterie board, I feel horrible. Need
to somehow balance this out to what is scattered out evenly. What do you think about this little thing, Dustin?
Good night, Carol. Mm-hmm.
What do you think about this? What do you think?
Oh.
It's like a starburst.
Mm-hmm.
I just have to even it
out. Are you just doing two?
Yes, I'm just doing two.
I feel like they need to be squeezed towards
squeeze? That's look weird if it squeezed.
Does it? No, not like that. I mean, just squeeze those tips.
Oh, like this? Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Oh.
Okay, fine. Fine. You're a genius. Fine.
No, you're a genius, baby. Can I get back to the charcuterie board?
Now. I am going to dry this, and I'm going to make sure that this is sealed. So this is really sealed up.
How do you get stones to stick to uneven surfaces?
Watch, I'm gonna seal it. I am going to seal it. Okay, let me put all the stone back together. All right, now. Let's take out the crystal sealers. This out. So normally let's go ahead and seal this one first. Okay. Actually, let's seal this one first. Seal the needle first. So I am gonna use the needles, and what I do is I tell my client to turn her hand over like this. Okay. And I will apply on the edge of the crystal. And the reason why I want to turn the hand over, so the gel oil will stay right on the edge like this. You see this? It stayed right on the edge. I do all on one side. And then they will flip the hand over for me after I flash cure this. 1, 2, 3. I will say, turn over for me. So when I feel this gap on one side, I do it on all finger. Index on the left. Middle finger on the left. Ring finger on the left. And pinky on the left. When I'm done with all that, flash cure all that. I would tell him, turn over, and I repeat the same thing. Okay. So this is what I do. Turn hand over, left, flash cure, left, flash cure, left, flash cure, on every stone, left, flash cure. That is a method of sealing. As I said, if your background is matte, if your background is acrylic, or if your background is like a soak up gel, I don't really seal it at all. But with a tricky background, especially with a shine, high gloss background, if the gel is a hot gel, then by all means, it's always helped to seal it.
That was beautiful watching. You captured the flow and under the edge of the stone beautifully.
Thank you.
And that's because there's a rogue stone on the table.
I know, right? You want it, aren't you? I know you want to pick it up. I'm just going to leave it like this. I know you want to pick it up. It's like a splinter. You can't help it.
We live with rogue stones.
I'm going to leave it right here to tease you. You can try to pick it up through the screen.
Good boy. Good boy.
Okay, so that's number one. That's how you sealed it, number one. Now, let me show you another one. For stone like this, okay, is see the whole surface is shiny. I am not gonna seal on both sides like that. I'm gonna twist so I can get the brush, because before I pull, I get the needle. Now I twist, I get the brush, and I am gonna brush gel all around it like this. The formula in this is just the same as a formula in Shine It. That's what made this pen a one-time purchase, because I always can refill it with Shine It, okay? So you have that all around the edge, and now you take Shine It, gel Shine It right here. That's the same thing in the pen bottles. You just stroke it all over like this. I love this way, especially when the stone, the crystal, the wall is really high. This can submerge it. I love it. Okay, turn it over so I can recenter and cure. So that is a couple of ways that you can seal. Again, normally I don't really seal, but I want to teach you guys that just so you can pack that knowledge of sealing, just in case on certain surface you want to seal it. So I'd be like, this is how I do this. This is a tool that I need, and have a flash cure. A flash cure is important. A flashlight or a plug in like this is important, because when you seal, you don't want to put your client hand into the machine every single time. That would take too long. So you want a machine that can quick cure, not complete cure by all means. There's people that doesn't know. You can have quick cures here. That's people that doesn't know and use a flash cure light as an actual lamp and then try to do chrome with it. No. But always have a flash cure with you. I couldn't live without my flash cure.
And as long as you're flash curing, you'll never hear them say, oh shit, I bumped the stone.
Right, no, never. Take control of the hand. All right, I'm going to remove this stone. There you go. Remove it. All right. right? All right. Now I'm gonna put all the stone back.
And I'm a little proud of myself.
What's that?
Well, because I know I'm looking at the getting kicked off of something differently. I figure if we say something that offends somebody,
yeah,
I would really want to know that because it wouldn't be intentional. And because we don't watch the news and we're not current and we're not
right
lingo and stuff.
We gotta be classy.
We could accidentally.
We gotta be classy when we wanna know someone. We gotta be classy about it.
Right. If we wanna intentionally do it, it's gonna be eloquent,
right,
it's gonna be intrusive, it's gonna be nonstop. And then after we get kicked off or whatever, then we'll be right there at the front door.
Like, oh, can you believe that? Oh, bless her heart. Be classy. All right, everyone. Thank you, Tanya. This set right here can make you a lot of money and many sets. Not just this. Like, you can do all 5 nails. Just pigment. Just pastel pigment like that. Top coat done. Or matte top coat done. You can do that. That is also a style. An airbrush blend style. Very popular. Elegant.
Like
they would dig it. You also can blend first and then take nude gel and ombre it on so it become an airbrush ombre set. It can also be another style.
Your body language becomes a vampire butterfly. Is
yeah, because you have to sell it to your client. Like, do you want this? And then you can add skin to it. But with a green unicorn chrome, you can give it a sheen layers of chrome, top coat, and done. Or you can matte that, and then you emboss to make contrast. You can use opal gel. You can use unicorn glitz.
Tanya wants to know, what can she do if she doesn't have opal gel?
Unicorn glitz. You can use, I think you opal gel, I'm just curious to see what it's like. You can use unicorn glitz, or Aurora gel, whatever glitter that is not opaque, it's see-through, so you can see the colors. If you don't have none of that, I hope you have the diamond flash. The diamond flash are the reflected glitters that also will show the colors. It will show the color too. So to any glitter element, to embrace it, make it glittery and flashy, because you know you're gonna see all the rainbow pastel spectrum.
Luckily she's got all the stuff for the backup.
Good.
Yeah, Tanya. What would you charge for a set like this?
Oh, a set like it, to me, it's not complicated, but you can charge a lot because it's beautiful and it's trendy. I have to go to the pigment process. Pigment process, maybe $100 or $150. Pigment, that's a lot of color. 4 different color. Let's say $150. And the layer of chrome, that's easy. Top coat and chrome, I charge another $10, $20. You know, $170. It's easy. Chrome is easy. If you have the right chrome and the right base. And then this emboss will make a heavy $50 more for an emboss pattern or more. So right now we're talking about $200, $250 to depend on your areas. And with crystal, this is not cheap crystals. With all crystal like that, I will make it $100 extra. Because this, every finger, it's gonna be on the thumb too. It's gonna be 10 finger crystal. $100 is cheap. $100 or $200. Oh yeah, they are real crystal. The certain city, they would draw $200. So $100 or $200 just depend on your confidence on your crystal. Of course, you're gonna make sure that it's lasting. Your client come back, or else you're not gonna be able to charge anything for it.
Right, right.
They're gonna be above you.
With those attached and shining the way they do, and they will get confidence.
They will bow down to you. They will bow down to you. But if a stone even come off. Right? If it doesn't last till they come back, they will own you. Next time they want crystal, they'll be like, how much is that? And then whatever price you say, they'll be like, But
what if I lose one?
But last time it's come out on me. Okay, what happens? The attitude.
You
want to be able to make it last until they come back, because then they'll be like, oh, can I get crystal again, please? You'd be like, 200. They'd be like, okay. Let me call my sugar daddy.
Right,
okay,
right.
Now, so you're looking at about 250, 300 a set.
Thank you, Kevin.
Good night, loving 313.
You had a question up here.
Okay, what question?
Actually, you had two of them. Lexa asked that. We'll get that one here.
Okay.
In a second. Hold on. Oh. Can you show everything you used to create all this?
Yes.
Maybe pile up, make a screenshot?
Yes. So let me put this right here, and I will show you the material.
And then it's Lex, or Lay, X's nose, hugs and kids. I don't know. It's not Lay, it's whatever you said the first time, but it's
like. Yes.
What?
Lieso.
Yes.
Lieso.
Yes.
Leah. Leah.
Wants to know what you do if you get artist block.
I don't get artist block.
I know.
I don't get
artist. No. Where do you get your inspiration?
Okay.
That's easier.
So the way I think is I piece things together like Tetris, and I have memory bank that I collected for years. So for you to remember something, you're going to love it. You're going around collecting detail. So you pull it out to use it later. That is if you have a visual memory. If you don't have a visual memory, you use your iPhone. Okay, so that's number one.
Little love file.
Yes. Number two, I use my color rules whenever I just don't feel like thinking about design in general. What I do is I select three different kind of color elements. Number one is mutuals. Mutual color is new, gray, black, white. Anything that doesn't have a hue on it is neutral color. It's number one.
Anything that does not have a hue on it.
Right. A color hue is a color spectrum, like red, blue, yellow, pink.
Got it.
Silver doesn't have any colors. White doesn't really have any. Black doesn't have any color. Brown is not really a color. Yeah, it's like mutual. So you have mutual color. Number two is main colors. Like, I like blue or blue and green. I wouldn't go too far. I just go like one or two colors, main colors. That's number two. Number three is metallic elements. It includes gold, silver, or rose gold, anything metallic. So let's say I don't want to design today. So I'm thinking pink. So I like pink, right? Maybe a little purple too. That's my main colors. Then I'm gonna use a fair skin nude. Nude with pink, right? So a couple of ombre, nude pink ombre, couple of solid pink with glitters, right? My metallic element, let's do gold or silver, right? So now I have nude pink silver. So now I'm gonna have a couple of ombre now, you know, up top of my head. A nude nail with a pink tips right there, right? And dress up that tip with some metallic silver using this metal effect and solid chrome, right? One finger completely solid silvers with some pink bedazzle crystal on there. You almost have a set already. See that? And then the ombre finger, the pink and nude ombre finger, add a few crystal right there on the cuticle. You got a trendy set already. So that is a common trendy set. Now you want to add a finger, the a signature, like add a heart or like a butterfly or something. You can think of just one finger. You can think of one fingers. The rest are already planned to the intricate color scheme.
So that, I hope they got that, but that was a basic format this. You cover so many different sets.
It is.
But not have to expand your mind.
It is. But it's a very powerful dose of medicine. I suggest you write it down. Because you'll forget it later. It's not something that is easy for people to absorb and remember.
But going forward for what you love, that's the best. That's That's when your best work's gonna shine.
This is my pigment base. I start out with pigment base. It's out of stock right now. It's coming soon. It's coming very soon. So pigment base is what I start out first. Then I choose. This right here is super pigment. So super pigment is 24, I think 24 a set, a whole set. So that's why I use super pigment after I kiss it for 60 seconds. When I have a background that I desire, then I go ahead and put in chrome base. So chrome base is what I use to adhere chrome. That's why I use for chrome base. Okay, so I apply it on, I cure for 60 seconds, then I drew my green unicorn chrome. This is my green unicorn chrome that I use after. So I see a beautiful sheen of green unicorn, but I still can see the background. See that? You can still see the blend of the background. It's see-through. So after I use it, I apply matte. This is what I apply right after. So everything now is matte. It's chrome, but it's matte chrome. That is when I go in with texture effect. This is clear texture gels. I apply clear texture gel on. That's it. Now the index and the pinky, I use a new element. It's opal. This is opal gel. I haven't had a lot of demonstration for it because this is not a special effect. It is skin. When I say a skin, I mean the colors. Like let's say a skin is something that are pretty. Like polish, that's a skin. Gel polish is a skin.
So skin equals layer?
Okay, a stained glass gel is not a skin because I can use it for shading. I can use it for special effect. Anything that are out of the ordinary. Anything that you cannot just look at the box, look at the gel and be like, this does it. No, you have to have education on it. That is special effect.
Right.
A skin is, you just look at it and you immediately know if you want it or not. You just look right at it. That is a skin. A skin is simply a color, a glitter, a sparkle. Use a dressing. So I'm using opal stone today because later on, I just want to find out if it's good with this set and it's fabulous with this set. But later on, I am going to use opal gel to create 4 gems, which means I'm going to draw like a circle and have like blue or something on it. And then I'm going to take this and I'm going to make it voluminous so it can look like a crystal. Since this right here, it can build up very, very high. So later on, I'm going to use it to make 4 gems and opal nails. So that is what I use. All right.
I think you answered everything and did everything.
Good. I'm not going to include the thing that I use for the glue because that is totally another group of products. It needs to be kept separate.
Thank you, Carol.
You are welcome, excellent class. You know, oh, you are welcome, Carol. Granadas. Some awesome, Tino. Thank you, Habibi Nails. All right, I will also go ahead and save the live tonight because tomorrow I'm gonna do another live and possibly TikTok. I don't know.
We'll see.
I will see.
We'll see.
I'm not promising TikTok, but I.
But we're not promising either.
But I'm not promising either. I like TikTok so far.
We need to feel dirty or not.
Right. Can't believe I get tips.
Plus, if we're gonna do something to learn a lesson, we need to do it early, right?
Right.
Because if we found at the show, we wouldn't mind being banned if we was doing something else.
Leia, say you really cheer me up tonight. Thank you.
Don't thank her. Say, well.
No, that's what she said.
Right. She cheered us up. You said, thank you. No, we combat it with, no, thank you for making.
No, she said that. She said that.
Right. We made her happy,
but she said thank you after. It's not for me.
Oh, okay. You didn't thank her. Okay, good. That's all I want to make.
But sure. Now you make it awkward. Now I feel like I have to thank her.
Oh, honey.
Or else it's awkward.
She made us pronounce things that we don't, we still don't even know we got it right. I know what it's not.
All right, Tanya. I will see you guys later. By the way, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of the only day that I stay in Missouri, I will leave Missouri Thursday and I won't come back until like the 20th for a beauty show. I'm not sure if I will be on in all 3 days, but I will try my best to be on. So tomorrow, I think I will be on. Yes, I know I'll be on tomorrow. Yeah, yeah. And I hope that I can be on Tuesday and Wednesday too. I'm pretty sure I can, unless I have a project. Like tonight, I gotta take an opal gel and put it on, the green opal gel.
So before I confuse everything, though, I just want to know, is it Lee XO? It's
Leia XO.
No, I'm asking because I think I got it right.
I don't know. I think I got it right.
Okay, what are you saying?
I might have to go slow for you.
Yes, we need to do the spelling thing for her.
Leia. But you have to say it like it's natural. Leia. So it's Leia.
I can't say that naturally.
See? But anyway.
It's Leah.
Fine. I was going to make it exotic.
We're going to rename you. We'll come up with something better.
All right, Leah.
All right,
so
Leah.
Now it's so normal.
Why did she do that?
It's Leah. All right, Leah. See you later.
Leah.
All right, bye-bye, everyone. I will see you tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central Time.
Everybody stay happy. Have a
bye-bye. Have a good night. And Australia, bye-bye. And in a different part of the world, good morning. Have a good day.